Hello class, welcome back to your online studies. So today we'll continue with our part 3. We are done with part 1 and part 2, and this is the last part of our chapter, the best Christmas present. So let's begin. I folded the letter again and slipped it carefully back into its envelope. I kept awake all night. By morning I knew what I had to do. I drove into Bridport, just a few miles away. I asked a boy walking his dog where Cooper Beaches was. House number 12 turned out to be nothing but a burned out shell. The roof gaping, the windows boarded up. I knocked at the house next door and asked if anyone knew the whereabouts of a Mrs. McPherson. Oh yes, said the old man in his slippers. He knew her well. A lovely old lady, he told me. A bit muddle-headed, but at her age she was entitled to be, wasn't she? 101 years old. She had been in the house when it caught fire. No one really knew how the fire had started, but it could well have been candles. She used candles rather than electricity because she always thought electricity was too expensive. The fireman got her out just in time. She was in a nursing home now, he told me. Burlington House on the Dorchester Road on the other side of the town. Now, once narrator had read the letter, he put it back into the envelope, and then he was awake all night thinking what he should do next. So what he does is, next morning he decides to visit the addressee of the letter. So he decides to visit Mrs. McPherson. So when he reached over there, he finds out that there is no house left. But instead of it, it was a burned out shell. That means only kuch hisse bache hue the us ghar ke wahan par. Okay, so what he does was he goes to the neighbor and then asks if he knows where Mrs. McPherson was. So the old man tells him that yes, he did know her. She was an old lady but bit muddle-headed. Muddle-headed means a little confused type. Jo budhape mein hota hai na, because she was 101 years old. So she was in the house when it caught fire. No one really knows the reason, but reason could have been the candles, because Mrs. McPherson used candles instead of electricity. She used to believe that electricity was quite expensive. So she was in the house when it got fire. So fireman had got her out just in time. Means agar unko thoda sa bhi aur late karte bahar nikalne mein, to she could have died because of the fire. So now, right now, she was living in a nursing home which was on the other side of town. I found Burlington House nursing home easily enough. There were paper chains up in the hallway and a lighted Christmas tree stood in the corner with a loop-sided angle on the top. I said I was a friend come to visit Mrs. McPherson to bring her a Christmas present. I could see through into the dining room where everyone was wearing a paper hat and singing. The matron had a hat on too and seemed happy enough to see me. She even offered me a mince pie. Now, he went to the nursing home that was on the other side of the town, and over there, he finds the matron and asks her about Mrs. McPherson, okay? He tells her that he was a friend of Mrs. McPherson and he was there to give her a Christmas present because this was Christmas Day. Now, over there, he sees everyone is wearing a paper hat and singing because it was Christmas Day, so everyone was kind of celebrating the Christmas. Alright, now she walked me along the corridor. Mrs. McPherson is not in with the others, she told me. She's rather confused today, so we thought it best if she had a good rest. So now he was able to see on the other side of the hall where there were so many people. So matron tells him that Mrs. McPherson is not with other people because she was a little bit of confused today. So they decided that it's better if she takes a little rest today. All right. So I'm sure she has no family, you know, no one visits. So I'm sure she'll be only too pleased to see you. She took me into a conservatory with wicker chairs and potted plants all around and left me. Then what she does is she tells him that she has no family, so no one ever visits her, so she'll be very happy to find a visitor finally. All right, so she takes him to Mrs. McPherson. The old lady was sitting in a wheelchair, her hands folded in her lap. She had silver white hair pinned in a wispy bun. She was gazing out at the garden. "Hello," I said. She turned out and looked up at me vacantly. "Happy Christmas, Connie," I went on. "I found this. I think it's yours." As I was speaking, her eyes never left my face. I opened the tin box and gave it to her. That was the moment her eyes lit up with recognition and her face became suffused with a sudden glow of happiness. So, as he sees her, Mrs. Connie. So, as he sees Mrs. Connie, he finds that she was quite old. She was sitting in a wheelchair and her hands were folded in her lap. She had white hair that were all pinned in a bun. Bun yani ki juda. So, wispy bun yani ki khilera sa bun. Okay. So, she had her hair in a bun. So, she was gazing out at the garden. She was looking at the garden. So, what this narrator does is, wo uske paas jata hai and he wishes her happy Christmas and gives her the letter. Alright, for a moment, she gets a little confused. Then she looks at him, she looks at the person, at the narrator, and she keeps looking at him. Okay, then initially she seemed a little confused, but when she opens the tin box, as I was speaking, her eyes never left my face. I opened the tin box and gave it to her. That was the moment her eyes lit up with recognition and her face became suffused with a sudden glow of happiness. So when he gave her the tin box and she opened it, then she realized what it actually was and her happiness spread all over her face. Alright, I explained about the desk, but about how I had found it, but I don't think she was listening. So he tries to explain her that how she found this letter. But he realized that she wasn't actually listening. For a while, she said nothing but stroked the letter tenderly with her fingertips. He was speaking, but she wasn't actually listening to him. She was just looking at the letter and she was stroking it with all the love and affection she had in it. Suddenly, she reached out and took my hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. "You told me you'd come home by Christmas, dearest," she said. "And here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim. Sit down." Now here what happens is she gets the letter and she thinks the person who's giving her the letter is Jim. Because in the letter, Jim had written that by next Christmas, war will be over and he will be with her by next Christmas. So what she thinks is that today was Christmas and Jim had finally come to her to celebrate Christmas. So she believes the narrator to be Jim. "I sat down beside her and she kissed my cheek. I read your letter so often, Jim, every day. I wanted to hear your voice in my head. It always made me feel you were with me. And now you are. Now you are back. You can read it to me yourself. Would you do that for me? Jim, dear, I just wanted to hear your voice again. I'd love that so much. And then perhaps we'll have some tea. I've made you a nice Christmas cake, marzipan all around. I know how much you love it." So, now that she believes that narrator is Jim, she tells him that how she used to read that letter every day and believing that someday he would come back and she how much she longed to hear his voice. So she asks him, ki, please sit down and please read out this letter to me. Main chahti hu ki tum khud mujhe apna letter sunao. And then later on we'll have tea and I'll make you your favorite Christmas cake. Here the story ends. Now there are two comprehension checks. जो आपकी फर्स्ट पार्ट के एक मिडिल में आता है दैट व्हाई डिड द ऑथर गो टू ब्रिटपोर्ट. सो फर्स्ट सेकंड आपका आता है हाउ ओल्ड वाज मिसेस मैकफर्सन नाउ वेयर वाज शी. तो पहला आपको बताना है कि ऑथर ब्रिटपोर्ट में क्यों जाता है. तो अभी जैसे कि मैंने आपको पहले बताया व्हाई डज द ऑथर गोज टू ब्रिटपोर्ट बिकॉज ही वॉन्टेड टू डिलीवर दैट लेटर बैक टू द पर्सन जिसको वो भेजा गया था. सो दैट इज द वन रीजन. एंड अगेन how old was Mrs. McPherson? This is mentioned in the story. And where was she? Again, this is also mentioned in the story. So, read the story again. Agar aapko book available nahi hai, to maine yahan pe narrate kari hai. So, keep listening the story again. You'll get the answers. Alright. Next comprehension check mein we have who did Connie McPherson think her visitor was? The first question is आपको क्या लगता है कि कॉनी मैकफर्सन को क्या लग रहा था उसका विजिटर कौन है. अगेन दिस इज मेंशन इन द स्टोरी. आई एक्सप्लेन इट टू यू. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू इज विच सेंटेंस इन द टेक्स्ट शोज दैट विजिटर डिड नॉट ट्राई टू हाइड हिज आइडेंटिटी. तो कौन सा सेंटेंस ऐसा है जिससे आपको पता लगता है कि विजिटर डिड नॉट ट्राई टू हाइड हिज आइडेंटिटी. तो ये आपको पता लगता है यहाँ पर आप यहाँ लास्ट पार्ट में देखिए I explained about the desk, about how I had found it. And also, अगर हम स्टार्टिंग से देखें, हम ये पूरा पैरा देखें, तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नरेटर एक्सप्लेन्स हाउ द ओल्ड लेडी वॉज सिटिंग इन अ व्हील चेयर, हाउ ही अप्रोचेज हर एंड हाउ ही टेल्स हर दैट आई फाउंड दिस, आई थिंक इट्स योर्स एज आई वॉज स्पीकिंग, ये है. इसके बाद आपका नेक्स्ट आता है, दैट वॉज द मोमेंट हर आइज लिट अप विद द रिकॉग्निशन एंड हर फेस बिकेम फर्स्ट विद ए सडन ग्लो ऑफ हैप्पीनेस. आई एक्सप्लेन्ड अबाउट द डेस्क, अबाउट हाउ आई हैड फाउंड इट, बट आई डोंट थिंक शी वॉज लिसनिंग. सो ही डिड एक्सप्लेन्स हर कि वो उसको कैसे मिला. तो अगर इफ ही इज ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन समवन कि मुझे कोई चीज़ कैसे मिली, तो ऑफकोर्स अपनी आइडेंटिटी वो छुपाने की कोशिश नहीं कर रहा है. सो ये वो सेंटेंस है जिससे पता चलता है दैट द ऑथर वॉज नॉट ट्राइंग टू हाइड हिज आइडेंटिटी. ऑल राइट, सो आपको मैंने पिछले दो कॉम्प्रिहेंशन चेक्स भी करने के लिए बोला था, एंड ये दो कॉम्प्रिहेंशन चेक भी आपको करने होंगे. फर्स्ट आप मेरे को ये कॉम्प्रिहेंशन चेक्स करके दिखाएंगे, उसके बाद वील कंटिन्यू विद दी मेन क्वेश्चंस. ऑल राइट, तब तक इफ़ यू वांट अ फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड पार्ट आप दोबारा पढ़ सकते हैं. इफ़ देर इज़ एनी कन्फ्यूजन यू कैन आस्क मी एनी टाइम यू वॉन्ट. देन क्वेश्चंस में भी कोई कन्फ्यूजन हो यू कैन आस्क दैट टू मी ऑल्सो, यू कैन आस्क दैट ऑल्सो. And once we are done with it, we'll start with the questions. Okay. Tab tak ke liye, thank you.